Hi kids, now can you see this picture on the screen? Yes, when we see the sun in the sky, we say that it is day. And when we see the moon in the sky, we say that it is night. So today in EVS 1 for Standard 4, we are going to learn the lesson day and night. Now, what differences do you see in the two pictures? What causes these differences? Now, let us observe and study the cause for these differences. In the first picture, it is morning, 6:45 a.m. As you can see, the time shown in the clock. And the sun rises, we get light from the sun, therefore we can see the things around us. And in the second picture, it is evening, 6:45 p.m. as you can see the time shown in the clock. As the sun sets, we do not get light from the sun, therefore we cannot see the things around us clearly. Now, why does this happen? We live on the earth. The earth gets light from the sun. The earth's shape is like that of a very large ball. Therefore, light from the sun does not reach the entire earth at one and the same time. Half the earth gets sunlight, while the other half remains dark. What happens to sun during the night? Where does it go? Now we'll see an activity to solve this and understand how day and night occurs. We need a bowl, a torch, and a glass. We have a picture of a house on the bowl. Now place the ball on the glass and switch on the torch in front. What will we see? The part facing the torch is in light, but the other part is in darkness. Is the house in the lighted or the dark part? Yes, it is in the lighted part. Now if you turn the ball, the picture of the house on it becomes dark, as it does not receive light from the torch. If you continue to rotate, the dark part of the ball gets lit up again. So the night follows day. Does the earth too turn around in front of a bright lighted object? Now imagine the torch is the sun and the ball is the earth. We say that it is day in the half that gets light, while in the other half where sunlight does not reach, it is night. Every day we see day chasing night, and then night chasing day. Night comes after day, and then day follows night. This cycle goes on without stopping. What could be the reason for this? Now let us study about that and understand it in a better way. Just as a top spins about itself, the earth too turns around itself. So the part of the earth that is getting sunlight goes into darkness, and the part that is in darkness comes into the light. That is where there is day. It becomes night after some time, and where there is night, it becomes day. So this process, that is the spinning of the earth around itself on its axis, is called rotation of the earth, as you can see in the picture. The earth takes about 24 hours to complete one rotation. Children, do you know? The sun rises in the east in the morning and moves towards the west. In the evening, the sun sets in the west. So we feel that the sun goes around the earth. But that is only an impression. Actually, the earth turns around itself. That is why we have day and night on the earth. The whole day has 24 hours. But day and night are not of 12 hours each all the year around. During the year, sometimes the days are shorter and sometimes the days are longer. Whereas sometimes the nights are shorter and sometimes the nights are longer. We will learn about the differences during the year, the duration of day and night during these times in detail. Now children, as you can see in the picture, it shows different dates and months. Now we shall learn about the duration of day and night from 22nd March to 21st June. On 22nd March, day and nights are both 12 hours long. Then in our part of the earth, daytime increases slowly and nighttime decreases. This goes on till 21st June. On 21st June, our day is the longest and the night is the shortest. Now let us learn the duration from 21st June to 21st September. From 21st June, in our part of the earth, daytime becomes shorter and shorter and nights become longer. On 22nd September, our day is of 12 hours and the night too is of 12 hours. Now let us learn the duration from 22nd September to 22nd December. From 22nd September to 22nd December, the day continue to become shorter and shorter and the nights continue to become longer. On 22nd December, our night is the longest and the day is the shortest. Now we shall learn the duration from 22nd December to 22nd March. From 22nd December to 22nd March, the day grows longer and the night shorter. This goes on till 22nd March. From 22nd March, this cycle repeats again. Children, do you know? In summer, days are longer and nights are shorter. Whereas in winter, nights are longer and days are shorter. Now children, always remember this. There is a connection between the seasons and the changing lengths of days and nights. So what have we learned? As the light of the sun does not reach the whole earth at the same time, there is daylight on half the earth while there is darkness on the other half. The earth spins around itself, so the part that faces the sun goes into darkness, and the part that is in the dark comes into the light. That is why we have day and night on the earth alternately. We can observe that the 24 hours of the day are divided into a 12-hour day and a 12-hour night on 21st March and 22nd September. From December to June, the day gets longer, while from June to December, the day gets shorter. I hope so you have understood the lesson and enjoyed watching the video. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe my channel and stay tuned for more videos. Bye-bye.